We've been living in Houston, Texas for about 12, 13 years now. So we've gone through quite a lot of hurricanes now, but I'm originally from the Midwest and I had no idea how to prepare for a hurricane when I moved here. We don't live anywhere near the coast, so I don't have to do anything like board up windows or anything like that. But today I'm gonna go over the 12 things that I do every time that a hurricane might be coming our way to get ready and prepare for possible power outages and long storm activity. Hopefully this helps any of you that have recently moved into hurricane territory and don't know where to start. So this is just the 12 things that I do before a hurricane comes, but you might need to do more depending on where you live, what the situation is in your house, or how close you are to stores, anything like that, how big the city is that you're living in. So just start with my list and think about the things that you might need to add. Talk to your neighbors and find out what they do. So if we hear that a storm is coming our way, it's usually 3 or 4 days ahead of time. Sometimes it's just 2, like it is with this current hurricane heading to Louisiana. One of the first things that we do is fill up our gas tanks or charge if you have an EV. Get your gas tank full or your car all the way charged up, just in case you need to evacuate when the gas stations aren't open because of power outage or because of storm damage. And sometimes there's long lines to get out of town on the highways. So you want to have fully charged or fully filled tanks ready to go. Number 2 is, even though we're really far away from the coast, we can still get really high winds or even tornadoes. Tornadoes have gone through my neighborhood before. So one of the big things that I do is go through our yard, get rid of any of the chairs, the outdoor dining table, anything that could possibly be blown around and cause damage to windows or other people's homes. So take all of that and put it inside your house or inside of your garage, inside of a shed, whatever you need to do. Tie down your trampolines, whatever you need to do if you're in the direct path of a hurricane. A third thing that I've been doing lately, especially since the Texas power grid is so bad that we might lose power for 3 or 4 days, and we've never been smart enough to put a generator on our house, the third thing I do is stocking up on a lot of ice just in case I need to pack a cooler with whatever's left in my fridge. That way I can keep certain items cold for a couple of days if we're gonna be stuck in the house without power. So like my milk, things like that that I'm gonna be using every day will go straight in the cooler. It's much harder to get ice once the storm is starting or once the storm has happened and you're waiting for repairs in your area. So do it beforehand, put it in your freezer. The fourth thing that I do with my family is try to eat all of the food in my fridge and my freezer that I won't be able to keep in a cooler. So we wanna eat up everything that we can that has to be refrigerated before the storm happens. And I don't wanna have a refrigerator and a freezer full of food that is gonna go bad if we don't have power for 3 or 4 days. When Hurricane Harvey came through here, we didn't have power for the better part of 5 days. It would come on and off for a couple of hours now and then, but we lost a refrigerator full of food during that. And when the last hurricane just went through Houston a few months ago, my husband was here by himself without power for 3 or 4 days. So again, I completely lost everything in the fridge and freezer because I wasn't here to help him get ready. Number 5 is, even though I'm eating all of the stuff that can perish out of the refrigerator and freezer, I stock up on things that don't have to be refrigerated. So that's gonna be your soups, your peanut butter, your tunas, your canned meats, all that stuff that you can eat without having to cook it or refrigerate it. Stock up on that stuff before the hurricane happens. When you're stocking up on food at the grocery store, don't forget to get those coffee crystals, tea bags, whatever you're gonna need to get your caffeine in too. One of the only things that keeps me sane when we're in a power outage situation like that is making sure I have my caffeine in the morning. It's gonna make me a lot happier. If you're the same way as me, make sure you can figure out alternative ways of getting that caffeine in your system without power or without milk even. If you have an outdoor grill that you can cook things on, that's great. You can cook things like pancake mixes that you can just add water to, things like that. I can cook on my gas stove during a hurricane, so I can light the stove even when we're out of power for months, so I can heat food up. So things that I know I can make. And don't forget, when it comes to getting food ready for losing power for 2 or 3 days, think about your pets too. What are they gonna need for 2 or 3 days if you don't have power? And I didn't mention it earlier, but that goes for the yards too. If you have dogs or cats, livestock outside, make sure that they are ready for the storm too. Lock things down, get their feed, everything that you need for them ready for the storm. You also need to stock up on water. So at the bare minimum, 1 gallon per person and 1 gallon per pet per day is what you're gonna need. So if you've got 4 people in your house and 2 pets, you're gonna need 6 gallons per day at minimum. And that doesn't include bathing or flushing toilets or even really washing dishes. That is just for drinking and cooking food to keep you alive. I have a separate video showing how I set up my long-term water storage so that I'm ready for emergencies like this. I have a big stock of water. It has all of the tips that you're going to need to do water storage at home. I'll link to that above and in the description below. Number 7 is to fill a bathtub or two, whatever you have in the house, with water. The bathtub water is going to be the water that you use to flush your toilets, do a little bit of a washcloth bath, things like that. So you're not going to use it for cooking or eating because it's not covered and anything can get in there, but it can be used for things like that. Number 8 is to make sure you have tons of emergency lights. Again, like I said, you could be out of power, especially in Texas where our power grid is so messed up. You could be out of power for 3, 4, 5 days. Honestly, after 2 days, I would be heading to a hotel, but some people don't have that option. So make sure that you have emergency lighting ready for at night. So the best option is going to be big LED lanterns. Little LED lanterns even these days can put out a ton of light. So get some of those. Number 9 is to make sure you stock up on all of the medication that you're going to need for the next week at least before the storm comes. So head to your pharmacy, grab everything that you're going to need for everyone in your house. Again, don't forget your pets. Number 10 is to make sure that you have everything charged in your house as far as tablets, computers, phones, all of those charged. And then also get those little power packs that can store up a lot of power too so you can recharge your phone again. Number 11 might be a little bit of a strange one, but I like to do all of the dishes in my house and all of the laundry before the storm hits too. Again, you don't know if you're going to be out of power for 3 or 4 days. You want to have all of your clothes available, all of your dishes clean before the storm hits so that you don't run out right away. And last but not least, even though I said to just wash your dishes, try not to use dishes. Having disposable plates and disposable silverware, disposable cups, just makes life easier when you don't have any power and you have very limited water for washing all these dishes anyway. So I recommend doing that. I know it's not ideal if you're trying to not have as much trash, but when you are living without power for 3 or 4 days, having some paper plates around the house is really, really helpful. All right, I hope this helped you get ready for hurricanes. If you're new to the South or new to living on a coastline where you've got hurricanes coming in, don't worry, it won't be too bad. Just prepare ahead of time. Get your mind right about it. Make sure that you're ready for reading books, reading magazines, doing a lot of drives around the neighborhood. Just make sure you're prepared ahead of time for entertaining everyone in the house without TV or internet, all that stuff. And like and subscribe to this video so you can see more of my DIY and homeowner tips. All right, good luck, guys.